A new version of my pattern cutting tutorial, Draft the Bodice Block, a simple and precise guide. This is the metric version. The fully featured ebook with detailed explanation is free. Visit my site angelakane.com/pattern cutting. Check the info button. I am using these measurements for this draft. Draw a rectangle. Make the width equal to a half hip plus 3 centimetres. Make the length equal to the back waist plus the waist to hip measurement plus 2.5 centimetres. A little more in larger sizes. Refer to nape line coming up. The waist to hip is usually between 21 and 23 centimetres down from the waist, or the level of your maximum hip measurement. Label the down lines as CB for centre back and CF for the centre front. And the bottom line is the hip line. The bodice back. We'll start with the bodice back. This is how the block will look when finished. The nape line. For an 88 centimetre bust, the nape line is 2.5 centimetres down from the top line. This is average for UK size 12, bust 87 centimetres. Add or subtract 0.25 centimetres for sizes smaller or larger, respectively. Measure down from the top line 2.5 centimetres. Label it nape line. Square across for a guideline of 8 centimetres or so. The waistline. To find the waistline, measure down from the nape using the back waist measurement. Square across to the centre front and label it waistline. The bust line. Measure down from the nape the half back waist measurement plus 1 centimetre. For bust over 100 centimetres, add 1.5 centimetre instead and label bust line. Square across to centre front. The bust line is also the armhole depth. The back neckline. Calculate the back neck width to find the neck point. To do this, divide the bust measurement by 8, add 3 centimetres and halve the result for the back neck width. For a bust of 88 centimetres, the back neck width is 7 centimetres. Another method for finding the back neck width is to divide the neck size by 5. Measure along the nape line and square up 2 centimetres. Label this the back neck point. Draw in a shallow back neckline curve, flattening out at centre back. Check the info button for free extras, including the free ebook of this series, my complete table of average measurements, the Imperial Measure version, guides for taking measurements, and everything else to do with sewing pattern drafting from angelakane.com. The back shoulder line. Measure 3 centimetres down from the nape line. Square across a guideline of about 25 centimetres and label it the shoulder line. The across back line. Find the midpoint between shoulder line and bust line, square across a guideline and label it the back line. Measure along the back line, half the back width plus 0.5 centimetres. From this point, square down to the bust line and up to the shoulder line. This is the armhole guideline. The back underarm point. Where this line meets the bust line, extend the line out 5 centimetres and label back underarm point. At the angle made by the armhole guide and the bust line, draw a guideline at 45 degrees and measure along 3 centimetres, a little less for small sizes and up to 4 centimetres for larger sizes. The back shoulder point. From the back neck point, draw a line equal to the shoulder length measurement plus 1 centimetre to wherever it meets the shoulder line. Complete the back armhole. Draw a curved line from the shoulder point to the underarm point. flattening through the point on the back line for about 3 centimetres. The shoulder dart position. Find the middle of the shoulder and draw a vertical guideline down 6 centimetres and measure 1 centimetre to the left. Use this as the end point of the shoulder dart. Draw a line back up to the shoulder midpoint. This is the dart centre line. The shoulder dart. Draw the dart lines up to the shoulder seam, 0.5 centimetres either side of the midpoint of the shoulder, giving you a 1 centimetre wide shoulder dart. The back hip point. Measure across from centre back along the hip line a quarter of the hip measurement and label back hip point. The provisional side seam. Join the back underarm point to the back hip point with a straight guideline. We will complete the waistline shaping later. Drafting the front bodice is next in part 2. Check out my other videos and pattern cutting on angelakane.com. If you like this format of tutorial, please let me know and subscribe for more of the same. Continue in episode 2. Thank you for watching this series.